Hello, everybody. This is Yechan Yoon from South Korea. How was your day? Do you guys having a great time? Today, we are going to learn about normal and formal with the Korean language. Okay? So, are you ready, guys? I'm going to share the screen and let's start directly. 3, 2, 1, let's go. There we go, like this, guys. Today we are gonna learn about normal and formal, about the Korea culture and the language. Okay? Korean thing important about the attitude and the reaction at the first time. Okay? So, let's say, if you meet some friend like this, then you can use the informal words. But usually, you know, if you want to make some like Korean friend or if you want to meet some Korean people with the first meeting, they always prefer the formal words because they really think about the attitude and the reaction as well. Okay, please remember about this one. If you become too more polite, then they will gonna answer with the polite. But sometimes, are really rude and really cold, but you know, every country is like that. So please remember this one, okay? So for the informal words, we can speak with 반말, 반말, like this, like 안녕, 잘 지내, 뭐해, like this guy, like this is called 반말, 반말. Informal words, okay? How about the formal words? You can say 존댓말, 존댓말. I will give you the example, like 안녕하세요, 안녕하세요, 반가워요, 고마워요, something like this, okay? Okay? So, as I told you, informal words, 반말, you can speak with friends. But for the formal words, you have to speak with the first meeting, or if you're greeting someone, you have to use the 존댓말. Okay? Right. Then let's go to the next one. Oh, for your information, I'm gonna use the N for the informal words. And for the semi-formal, I'm gonna use the S. And for the formal, I'm gonna use the F for the simplified word. Okay? Then let's go with the beginning. Myself, you know how to explain yourself, right? So we're gonna learn about the myself, how to pronounce myself. For I, we can say with na, na, with informal word, guys. Okay, how about the formal word? You can say 저, 저. Okay, how about my? You can say 내, 내. With the informal words. How about the formal words? You can say 제, 제. Okay? How about the mind? How you can say 내 것, 내 것, 내 것, 내 것. With the informal word, guys. How about the formal words? You can say 제 것, 제 것, 저희 것. But we usually simplify with the 내 것. Okay? How about you? How you can say with you? You with the informal words, we can say 너. 너. But with the formal words, you can say 당신. 당신. Okay? How about the your? Your, you can say 너희. 너희. I'll give you the example though. Your name. Name is like 이름. 이름. Okay, I'm gonna write down in here, guys. Your name. And for the name, you can say 이름. 이름. Okay? Then how you can speak it? Your. And 너의 이름. Like this. That it means your name. 너의 이름. All right? Like this, guys. But I'm going to remove this one for our practical class, okay? Like this. 5, 4, 3, 2, all right, whatever. Okay, let's go to the next one. Yours. How you can say with the yours? Oh, sorry, sorry. I didn't explain the formal, right? So for the your, you can say 당신의. 당신의. So 너 and 당신 is the same like a you, but you have to put some 의. 의 with the your. Okay, so your informal is 너의. Formal words, 당신의. Okay, how about the yours? How you can say? You can say 내 것. 내 것. 내 것. 내 것. With the informal, guys. Okay, how about the formal? You can say 당신 것. 당신 것. 당신. You can say 당신의 것. But 당신 것. You can also say with that. Okay? So I'm going to write down like this. But you can just use the 당신 것. Okay? 당신 거예요. 당신 것. 당신의 것. Okay? That is the formal word. How about the male? With the he. He is his. Okay? So with the he, you can say 그, 그, with the informal, okay? You can say 그. How about the formal? You can say 그분, 그분. How about the his? You can say 그의, 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 okay? Exactly, just put some 의 with the 그, okay? How about the his with the formal? Just exactly say, 그분의, 그분의. Okay, how about his things? How you can do it? With the normal words, you can say, 그의 것, 그의 것. But you also can say, with the formal, 그분 것, 그분 것. Or you can say, 그분의 것, 그분의 것. But we usually speak with the 그분의 것, with the 그분의 것, 에. Because looks, if you listen it, it sounds like more like difficult. 그분의 것, it's really hard to pronounce it. So they usually speak with is or speak for easily with 그분의 것, 그분의 것. Okay, but you also can speak 그분 것 as well. Okay, so please remember both of it. Okay, next one. Female. How you can say she? You can say 그녀. 그녀. How about the formal? 그분. Oh, don't you think that is the same thing with the he, right? Male and female with the formal word is almost same. But you can see the situations, right, when you speak it. So you can just tell them with the 그분, but also you can explain about that. About the situation with a female, she's a female and a male. You can explain further at the next time, okay? But for the writing, we using same words with the male and female for the formal, okay? So please remember it. She is 그녀, 그녀 in informal. For the formal, you can say 그분, 그분. How about the her? You can say 그녀의, 그녀의. Formal is the same with the male. 그분의, 그분의. Hers, hers things. How you can say? 그녀의 것, 그녀의 것. Or 그분의 것 is the formal. 그분의 것. Okay? 나라 그분의 것. I think it's 그분의 것, but you have to pronounce as 그분의 것. 그분의 것. Okay. Next one. Group. Group. They. How you can say they? You can say 그들. 그들 with the normal. How about the formal guys? You can say 그분들. 그분들. Okay, so 분 means like make some people with the more respect words. Okay, let's say example. If you when you go to the restaurant and the waiter is gonna ask you like how many people was did you coming with, then them is if we using with the Korean they say 몇 분이서 오셨어요. You only need to understand about the 분. Listen carefully. 몇 분이서 오셨어요? 몇 분이세요? It means you can listen some 분, right? So 분 means about the 분 is exactly the people, how to counting the people, how to pronounce the people with the formal words. Okay? So they just put the 분 in here to using this word to making some formal words. Okay? So 그들 is the informal. 그분들 is the formal. 그분들. Okay? How about the there? You can say exactly the same. Like 의, 의. So 그들의. 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 Okay? How about the formal? You can just use the 그분들 plus 의. So 그분들의. 그분들의. But we usually not speak with 그분들의 것이야. We usually say 그분들의 것이야. Okay? Please don't confuse it. How about the theirs? Exactly the same. 그들의 것. 것 is the thing. Okay? 것 is the thing. So 그들의 것. If you're using with the formal words, you can say 그분들의 것. 그분들의 것. You can speak like that. Okay? All right. So, for this one, I'm just gonna give you for the gift, okay? So actually, this one is just for, this one is for the advanced class, but we're gonna learn, so we're gonna start to learn because we already learned a lot of basic components, right? So we're gonna start to learn some like advanced like words or like a sentence for the conversation with step by step, okay? So, for the hello and goodbye, we're going to learn about today, okay? For the hello, with the informal words, you can say 안녕. 안녕. Okay? How about the formal? You can say 안녕하세요. 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 We also have another one. This one we usually using for the business guys, business. So like when you go to the like public like seminar or like a presentations, if you need to speak like one or two sentences with the Korean, you can use this one. 안녕하십니까? 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 This is also the formal words, but like a formal. Okay? All right. Next one. How you can say goodbye? With the informal words, you can say 잘 가. 잘 가. But guys, please remember it, okay? Korean doesn't like to listen some informal word with the first meeting or at least you're not get close to enough. Okay? Then how you can say with the formal words, you can say 잘 가요. 잘 가요. Okay? 요 makes some like a sentence to become to the formal sentence. Not with all of it, but like generally. Okay? So please remember this one. But we can also using another goodbye with these situations when you leaving. Okay, so you have a like conversation with the other people and then you're gonna leave. Then that people is gonna be staying in that place, right? Then you can use 안녕히 계세요. 안녕히 계세요. 안녕히 계세요. 안녕히 계세요. Okay? How about that person is leaving? Then you can say 안녕히 가세요. 안녕히 가세요. 안녕히 가세요. 안녕히 가세요. 안녕히 가세요. You can use this one. Okay? All right. For the tips, I'm not gonna give you right now. After the review, then we're gonna learn about the tips for the Korean. Okay? So we learned about the normal and formal for today's class. Korean think important about attitude. Korea think about attitude, reaction, really important. Okay, so please, if you want to say something to the Korean, or if you want to get close to the Korean, if you want to make some Korean friend, you need to know how to speak the formal words. Okay, they will gonna help you to how to, if you guys are get close enough to the Korean, then they will teach you with the Korean word, with the normal, informal words, okay? Attitude is the really important thing, so please remember this point, okay? Korean, think about the attitude, reaction, really important. Please don't forget about it. For the informal words, usually speak can speak with friends. Friends, okay? With the first meeting, you can use the formal words. You can use, not you can use, you have to use, okay? For the informal word, how you can say, you can speak with 반말, 반말, okay? How about the formal word? You can say 존댓말, 존댓말, okay? For this one, informal, I'm gonna write down with the N, semi-formal, I'm gonna use it with the S. For the formal, I'm gonna use for the F with the simplify, okay? Let's go. Myself, how you can say? I, you can say 나, 나. With the formal, you can say 저, 저는, 나는, 저는, I. Okay, how about the my? With the informal, you can say 내, 내. Formal words, 제, 제. How about the mine? 내 것, 내 것. With the formal, 제 것, 제 것. Okay? Next one, you. How you can say? You with an informal word is 너, 너. How about the informal words? 당신, 당신. Okay? How about the your? 너의, 너의. I told you, 의, writing is the 너의, 너의 것이야. We usually speak with, but it's like this, but most, like many of the people also can speak with 너의 것이야, 너의. Writing is 의, but you can speak with 에, 너의 것. Okay? How about the formal words? 당신의, 당신의, or 당신의, 당신의. Okay? Yours, how you can say? 내 것, 내 것. But if you want to speak with the yours, with the formal, is the 당신 것 or 당신의 것. 당신 것, 당신의 것. Okay? How about the male? How you can say with the he, you can say 그, 그. Formal words, 그분, 그분. His. 그의, 그의. Sounds like, so, 그의, 그의. How about the formal? 그분의, 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 그분의. Okay, how about the his things? You can say 그의 것, 그의 것. With the formal words, you can say 그분의 것, 그분의 것. With the female side, as I told you, formal is going to be the same, but with the informal, you can say 그녀. 그녀. With the formal, it's the same with the male. 그분. 그분. Or 그 여자분. 그 남자분. But we can just say 그분. Okay? Her. How you can say 그녀의. But with the 그녀의 also can be right. Okay? 그녀의. 그녀의. Okay? How about the formal? 그분의. Or 그분의. 그 여자분의 or 그분의 okay? Hers, how you can say? 그녀의 것 or 그녀의 것 그녀의 것 그녀의 것 How about the formal? 그분의 것 그분의 것 or 그분의 것 그분의 것 Okay, you can use the both of it. How about the group? How you can say, guys? How you can say? They, you can say 그들, 그들. How about the formal? 그분들, 그분들. Okay? How about the there? You can say 그들의 or 그들의. 그들의, 그들의. Formal words, you can say 그분들의 or 그분들의. 그분들의. 그분들의 theirs how you can say 그들의 것 그들의 것 or 그들의 것 그들의 것 formal words 그분들의 것 그분들의 것 or 그분들의 것 그분들의 것 okay all right how about the hello and goodbye you can say 안녕 안녕 with the informal words but if you want to speak with older people or want to be more respectful you can say with 안녕하세요 안녕하세요 okay with the business you also can speak with 안녕하십니까 안녕하십니까 the formal formal okay 안녕하십니까 you can use this one okay how about the goodbye 잘 가 잘 가 it's informal how you can speak with the formal words 잘 가요 잘 가요 잘 가요 also you can use the more formal words when you're leaving you can say 안녕히 계세요 안녕히 계세요 okay how about the person is leaving you can say 안녕히 가세요 안녕히 가세요. Okay. Please don't forget about it. Okay. Tips for Korean. Look at this. Tips for Korean. They don't like to receive sudden questions or conversations. Do you know what that means? Okay. Let's say when you go to South Korea and when you're trying to travel and if you want to talk with the Korean people, if you're not asking some, like, excuse, or suddenly just go and, hi, 안녕, or, like, 잘생겼어요, like, you're handsome, or whatever. Like, if you're, like, asking suddenly, or if you're trying to, like, if you're trying to speak with the Korean, like, unexpectedly, then they're gonna say, like, who are you? Like, they were gonna like, oh, who's this guy? You know, even in another country, guys. It's just like a common sense. If you want to say something to the others, you have to have a permission to excuse to the other people, right? So, you have to use excuse me. Excuse me, but I'm gonna teach you about the excuse me next time. Okay? But don't worry, guys. They are really kind of like a defended person. People in the Korea, but if you guys are polite, then most of the Korea will get more polite to you. Like they were gonna help you how to go there, you know, how to reach there, like how to find there. Okay, so don't worry, guys. Please remember the attitude, guys. Okay. All right. Then practical time. Okay, so we are learning about the I and you and he, she and them, they, right? Then let's try that. Well, let's try this one. Okay, book. You can say check, check. Okay. Get book, you can pronounce with check. Then how you can say with, how you can say with this, my book. My book. I'll give the 10 seconds, guys. It's an informal try. Let's try with the informal. Informal. Okay. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How, what was the name? What was the my? With the informal was me. Then what you can say? How you can say? Ne? Check. That's all. Ne? Check. Okay. Well, you can say nai check. Nai check. But ne check is also the same words. Okay. So I'm going to write down for you. So you can speak both of it, but net check or nai check. Nai check. You can use both of it. Okay. So this is the informal. Okay. Please remember it. Okay. How about another one? Okay. Chicken. No, chicken. Okay, 사과. Apple. You can speak with 사과. 사과. Okay? You can say your apple. But with the formal, guys. With the formal. How you can say? Try. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's try. There we go. 당신의, and how you can say? 당신의 사과. 당신의 사과. Okay, this is the how you can pronounce it. 당신의 사과. Okay, another one. Oh, previous class one. Father. With the formal. Okay, formal. We learned it, right? What is it? What was it? 아버지, right? 아버지. There we go. My father, how you can say, guys? My father with the formal words. I'll give it 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's check it out. How you can say my with the formal? There we go. 제. Then how you can say? 제 아버지. Okay. 제 아 or I told you what you can say. 저 우리 아버지. But we usually use this one. But this one is also can be right. Okay? 저. So just remember all of it. Okay. Remember all of it. 저희 아버지. Okay? Like this. Okay, one last one. Okay. Clothes. You can say 옷. 옷. Okay? How you can say? Her clothes. Her clothes. With informal. 10 seconds. 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Let's go. She. Where is the female? There we go. Her is 그녀의. 그녀의. Okay, then how we can say with "옷" with the adding with adding with "옷"? 그녀의 옷. 그녀의 옷. Okay, this is the how you can writing down. All right. So, how was it, guys? Was it difficult? For this class, you only need to learn about the, what is the important thing about the formal and what is the normal word that is, okay? Please remember that all the Korean really think about the attitude and the reaction really important, okay? So if you want to make some Korean friend or if you want to go another place in the South Korea, if you learn the Korean with formal words, it's gonna be super duper useful to you. If you're polite, then they will gonna try to give some more and trying to like help you more. Okay? So it's about all about your attitude. So I hope our all students can be make some really nice attitude to everybody. Okay? If you guys have any question, you can write down at our general help. And please do not miss our Kahoot quiz after this on this class. Okay? Then have a great day, guys, and see you at next Korea class. Bye-bye, guys.